Hi, I'm Jason from the Google Sign-In team. I'm going to talk with you about helping more Google users sign into your app or website. Connecting with your users is important to you. It's how you build a stronger, more meaningful, and sometimes more profitable relationship with them. But some users may not be willing to jump right into a deep, committed relationship. Asking for this level of commitment too early can turn users off and make them think of connecting to your app as cheap and unimportant. People naturally build trust in a relationship over time. That's why we're excited to tell you about incremental authorization. With incremental auth, you can let your users connect with your app, see what you're all about, then decide to deepen that relationship. When you ask a user to authorize your app to access data during sign-in, she is presented with a screen that describes the data your app is trying to access. It's up to you as the developer to put yourself in her shoes. Ask yourself, will she understand why I'm asking for a certain permission? Are there so many permissions that it seems scary to sign into my app? If she clicks through without reading or understanding exactly how a permission works, how will she feel later if she finds out she granted me this permission? All of these answers may affect the trust that your current and future users feel towards your app. If your answers point to showing fewer permissions, you need something that will simplify signing into your app. To do this, you can use incremental auth. With incremental auth, you can ask your user to give just a basic set of permissions that are easy to accept, like accessing her profile information. Profile information includes her Google user ID, full name, and profile image. With just this basic connection, you now have a way for her to connect with your app across different platforms with just a single tap or click. You can also personalize her experience by showing her profile image and name inside your app. Your app may also have great collaboration or sharing features. After using it for a while, your user may find it useful to sign in to more Google services within your app. For example, if your app allows him to create images, he may want to upload them to his Google Drive or share them on Google+. Incremental auth enables you to ask him for these permissions at exactly the right time when he has already expressed interest by interacting with a saving or sharing feature in your app. By providing the proper context for the decision, your user already knows he's ready to use more features of your app, to be more involved in your app's community, and to tell his friends to come join him in that community. Letting your user understand why you're asking for authorization before asking for it can dramatically increase sign-in conversions, leading to more users with a deeper involvement in your app. It's that simple. You can use Google Sign-In today to connect any Google user to your app or website. If you offer an option to connect with Google+, we make sure they have a Google+ account set up before your app uses Google+ features. But feel free to use any Google API, such as YouTube or Drive. Consult the documentation for the specific API to decide which permissions you need to ask for before calling the API. And remember, it may be best to ask for permissions one at a time or to ask for a few at a time. The list just needs to make sense to the user so they can feel confident granting your app the access it needs. By using incremental auth and building a relationship with your user over time, you can build a long-term, harmonious relationship with them. I'm Jason from the Google Sign-In team. And you just learned how incremental auth can help you to grow your signed-in Google users. For more information on how to get started with incremental auth, check out these pages on our developer site and get ready to grow with Google. Thanks for watching.